subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you never miss any update.
Hi all, welcome to yet another video. In this video I'll show you how to create an e-bicycle which can be easily afforded by almost everyone. I will also discuss about the price, the maximum kilometer covered on a single charge, the maximum speed and the time required to charge the battery and much more. So please watch the video till the end. This time I'm specially doing this video for my Indian subscribers. As you know, the rising petrol price is making difficulties for the daily commuters, and through this project, people who travels on range of 20 to 30 kilometers can easily take the benefit of this e-bicycle. And moreover, it's totally pollution free. So let's get started. Let's check the required components for doing this project. From past couple of months, I was doing research in building an e-bicycle, and I was mainly focusing on few things like cheap price, good speed, the kilometer that can cover on a single charge, waterproof, universal kit which can fit with any type of bicycle, lithium ion battery for the battery pack instead of traditional lead acid batteries. I've gone through almost every online website for finding a kit which matches these criteria. Most of the kits that I've seen were either coming without a battery pack, or even if you somehow manage to find a kit with a battery pack, those were selling at very high price and cannot be afforded by a common man. Finally, I found a vendor called R2H, a UP based company. The kit which they were selling exactly matched with my requirement. The kit called E-Ride Light Electric Bicycle Conversion Kit. I approached the vendor, and after telling about the requirement and about my YouTube channel, they offered me the kit on a special price. So I'll be doing a small review about this product as well. Let's understand how an electric bicycle works before explaining the kit that I've bought. An electric bicycle will be having the following components apart from the bicycle. They are electric motors, battery, controller and throttle. Now let's see how it works. The throttle is actually a potentiometer which is connected with the controller inside the battery pack. And once you rotate the throttle, the resistance will vary and signal will pass to the controller according to the change in resistance. According to the change in resistance, the controller will control the speed of rotation of hub motor through the pulse width modulation signal. So the working principle totally differs from the normal internal combustion engines that you could see in your motor vehicles, which are running mostly on mechanical parts. Here the only mechanical part is the hub motor, rest all are electronics parts. Now let's unbox the e-bicycle kit. The kit contains mainly the following components: rear wheel assembly with motor, battery pack with built-in controller, throttle, LED display gauge and a charger. They will also provide you battery pack mounting bracket, Allen key and cable ties. Now let's have a closer look. This is a 26 inch rear wheel assembly with a 36 volt 250 watt hub motor. This kit is available with 24 inch wheel option as well. This kit is available with the rear wheel option only. If you wish to put this on front wheel, then you have to change the fork. Fork used for fat tires goes well with this kit. It means in case of fat tire cycle, you can use this kit in front wheel instead of rear, but I would suggest you to fit this kit on rear wheels only. The rim is made of aluminium and they have used good quality spokes as well. The battery pack will provide the required voltage to rotate the hub motor through this wire. The battery pack contains a 36 volt 7.8 ampere hour lithium ion battery and the built-in controller. We need to put our keys here to power on the kit. This is a plus point. If you park it somewhere, then you need not to worry that somebody will ride or steal your bicycle. You could also see few sockets present on bottom side of the battery where we'll be going to connect the components such as the LED display gauge, throttle and the hub motor. These sockets will also help us for easy assembling of the kit onto the bicycle. This is the throttle. This is just like the accelerator what we see in motorbikes. The only difference here is it has got electronic components instead of mechanical components. We'll be controlling the speed of the hub motor using this throttle. And it has also got nice grips which will help us to make our ride even more comfortable. This is the LED display gauge. This is the on-off switch. The mode button is used for adjusting the speed. This button is used for walk mode. And this is the battery level indicator, and this section will display the speed of your bicycle. This is a 42 volt 4 ampere charger used for charging your battery. Using this charger, your battery will get fully charged within 3 to 4 hours. I was not quite happy with the packing and shipping method used by the vendor because the box was having two big holes while I received the kit. I've also seen few scratches on the kit which might have happened during the transportation. I've already shared my feedback with them. I hope they will work out on this. I'm going to fit this kit on my Hero Sprint 26 inch gear bicycle that I bought 1 month back. The cycle cost me around 8,500 rupees including all the accessories. This cycle is coming with 21 gears and both gears and gear shifters are from Shimano. If you wish, you can buy a cheaper one or else you can also use an old bicycle so that we can further reduce the total cost of the project. I'll be doing further reviews after fitting the kit onto the bicycle. I would recommend you to approach the local bicycle shop to fit the components onto the bicycle. First of all, we need to take out our rear wheel from the bicycle. Remove the free wheel and get it fixed onto the wheel that came with the kit. Be very careful while fixing the free wheel. Do not damage the wires coming out from the hub motor. If the wire is damaged, then your kit will not work and you will end up with wasting the money spent for buying the kit. So please be very careful with this. Now you can remove the tire from the old rim and fix it to the new rim. Now fix the rim back to the cycle. You can take out both handlebar grips from the handle and fix the throttle on the right hand side and the LED display gauge on the left hand side. You may also need to take out the left side brake lever to fit the LED display gauge onto the handlebar. Now it is time to fix the battery pack. Manufacturer recommend us to fit the battery pack on the back side or on the front fork. But I thought it is better to fix it on the top tube of the chassis, which will equally distribute the weight and will give a good balancing while riding the bicycle. To do this, I went to the local welding shop and made two clamps. I used bicycle tube to avoid the friction between the clamp and the battery pack, which may damage the battery pack while riding the bicycle. Let's finish assembling the kit by connecting the wires from LED display gauge, throttle and the hub motor to the battery pack. Let's do it one by one. Make sure to use cable ties to fix the wires properly onto the chassis. The arrow shown in these two connectors must be in face to face. If not, your hub motor will not work. So finally, I have finished assembling the kit after adding two more cable ties to get more perfection. Now it is time to take out for a road test and do the further reviews. The total weight of this kit is around 7 kg. That means your bicycle will put up an extra 7 kg weight after installing this kit. But no need to worry. This kit can easily carry a payload of around 150 kg. So two men weighing up to 70 to 75 kg can easily travel on this bicycle. Now let's see how to turn on this kit. Put your keys inside the socket present on the battery pack to turn on the kit. Now press and hold the on-off button for 2 seconds to start up. You can also adjust the speed of the motor using the mode button. There are 3 speed modes present, low, medium and high. You can set it according to your preference. Once you select the mode, now rotate the throttle slowly just like riding a motorbike. That's it. You are now riding an e-bicycle which is totally eco-friendly and pollution-free. The maximum speed of this kit as per company specification is 25 km per hour. On our ride, we got the same speed. We can further increase the speed up to 30 km per hour using the combination of both throttle and pedaling. All parts coming with this kit is waterproof, so you can take it for a ride even in rainy seasons. The vendor says this kit can cover 20 to 25 km in a single charge. Again, this is depending upon the type of the road, environmental condition and the payload it is carrying. This kit only requires around 2 rupees electricity to fully charge the battery. This means you can travel 20 to 25 kilometers in just 2 rupees, which is again a plus point. During our test, we got 20 kilometer mileage on a single charge without pedaling. If you wish to increase mileage, then you can use the combination of both pedaling and throttle. The price of the kit is 19,750 rupees including GST plus shipping charges. Please visit link in the description to get the website links for buying this kit. So you can easily complete the project within 21 to 22,000 rupees if you manage to buy a second hand bicycle. From my past couple of months research on e-bicycle kits, I feel this is the cheapest one which is currently available in India. While considering some other features, there is no pedal assist mode on this kit, which you can see in some modern e-bicycle kits, which will help you to automatically turn on the electric motor to provide assistance when you are pedaling. Similarly, no regenerative braking system present, which will help the motor act as a generator that charges the onboard batteries with electrical energy while you apply the brake. But again, I don't think regenerative braking is that much effective in bicycles. But while considering the price of the kit, I again don't feel absence of these features are a big drawback of this kit. Talking about the warranty, the kit is also coming with a 6-month manufacturer warranty. So as far in India, battery operated two-wheelers with electric motors that has a power rating below 250 watt or an electric bike with traveling speed restricted to 25 to 35 km can be sold and operated on the roads without the need for formal registration, and the driver doesn't require a driving license either. That means you are free to ride this bicycle anywhere in India without any worries. I would also request you to support Go Green India by taking the benefit of electrically powered vehicles. This is the time for us to think for our next generation as well. So that's it. Please let me know in the comment box if you have further doubts about this video. Thanks all for watching the video. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you like this video.